Have you ever struggled with creating exterior visualizations from your dream and it didn't come out exactly as you wish? Don't worry, as today we'll talk about how to create a perfect exterior image. Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Aga and I'm a CG artist. And on this channel, we explore techniques and tools that will help you become a better artist. Today, an important topic: exterior visualizations. I will give you tips on what to do to create a perfect exterior image. But before we start, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you aren't already, so you won't miss any future tutorials. So let me start with a little background story. There was a point in my 3D artist life where I was quite happy with my visualizations, but I still felt that I can do some things better. I always loved to do interiors, but exteriors also made me fun. And I knew that if I don't get to my desired level, not only will I be unhappy, but also I will struggle with finding new clients. So my goal was to improve, so I can create super realistic exteriors with soul. So I knew that I need to find out what is a real issue. Let me know in the comments if you are at the same point in your professional life now. Do you feel the same? So we need to agree that exterior images are more difficult above all in terms of nature details. Plants, for instance, can add life to your image, add character and atmosphere, but at the same time, they can make your image super unrealistic if you don't use proper models, for instance. So let me share with you some tips I have learned back then that helped me to improve and can help you as well. As I mentioned a few seconds ago, high quality models are the key in the exterior images. And it above all includes all sorts of trees, plants, flowers, shrubs, and so on. Let me give you an example. So in this scene, plants play a key role. If you won't use high quality plants, it will look totally unrealistic. Models make or break your image. So no matter how great lighting materials we create, if even one model is not perfect, it will catch the viewer's attention and the spell will be broken. So remember, always use high quality models. When we talk about models, it's really important to mention that in nature, we have different types of the same plant, as well as different types of plants in general. So if we want to create a photorealistic image, we have to use various models of different plants. Let's go back to the previous example. Here, you can notice that there we use lots of plant species, but even if some are not visible at the first glance, they will help to achieve this natural look. In the exteriors in particular, using advanced materials is a key. If you want to achieve a photorealistic look, many times you have to use materials with many layers or some advanced techniques that may be tricky if you don't know how it works. Let me give you some examples for better understanding. So in this shot, to create the snow on the asphalt, we needed to use techniques like texture painting and masking to recreate snow on top of the asphalt. Here on another side, the challenge was to create an effect of asphalt that is wet with puddles on top of it. Another example, when we created this beach sand material, we needed to create material with 5 layers to achieve this realistic look. And here, to create this ground material, we used 4 layers of different material using high quality textures. So to create advanced materials, first of all, you need to have a great understanding of materials in real life, but also you need to have the knowledge of different techniques to achieve desired effect. I've talked about this a lot on this channel. If you want to create visualizations that grab attention, you have to add a story to your images. Let's do the example. A great example will be this hotel shot, that without this man getting out of the car, we'll be lacking something, the soul and character. Thanks to this simple addition, the image makes sense and gives a context. Now, the best part is that these four images I've just shown you are the part of our brand new advanced exterior visualization training. So you can learn with us how to create images like this step by step. I promise it will be lots of advanced knowledge and everything you need to know to create images like this. Creating super advanced materials, creating nature scenarios, creating different seasons, setting up the camera according to the composition rules, using post-production to add atmosphere, using fog and volumetrics, creating different lighting scenarios, using forest park and rock lawn, editing plants in GrowFX, and much, much more. And all of this in 3ds Max and both render engines, Corona and V-Ray, in one course. More than 100 lessons and lots of great bonuses. 3D assets worth 1,000 euros in total and plenty of discounts. Plus, the book, The Art of RV's Images for free, for orders placed in the next couple of days. So definitely check it out if you want to create images like this. I put the link to the course in the description and in the corner. So check it out. Okay, with that being said, let's move to the next point. Lighting and post-production can be your greatest weapon, as well as the greatest enemy. It can add mood and atmosphere to your images, but it can create a total disaster as well. So it's important to recreate natural scenarios. Keeping balance between lighting and shadows, adding contrast, creating a good base in 3D, and using post-production to add a specific character and balance the colors. Look at this image. On the left-hand side, you can see the image before posting in Photoshop. And on the right-hand side, we have an image with full post-production. Of course, the difference is huge, but the base was good and the post only added extra contrast, mood, and color balance. Talking about colors, I need to mention that it's super easy to get an exterior image with too many colors. It's because you have plants with many tints of green or yellow, you have flower colors, plus you have this blue sky, perhaps you have buildings that have their own colors, people, cars, signs, etc. So if you want to create an image on the highest level, you need to pay attention to details and you have to adjust your colors on your image. If you don't know much about colors, I put the link in the corner to the video where I talk about it. References may be even more important in exterior images, because we don't spend too much time outside as we do inside. So we don't look at the stones, flowers, grass, water, etc. as many times as the things in interiors. For this reason, it's always good to have various of references when we want to recreate nature. And Pinterest or Google Graphics are a great source, a great tool for this task. This is a must in every type of shot. And I wouldn't be me if I didn't mention it here as well. Composition is the top thing we need to consider when creating an image. And we can try different variations of the camera. We don't have to follow exact composition rules, but we should follow the guides to some point to be able to create well-composed images. And at the highest level, your camera setup should tell a story per se. If you haven't watched my video on composition, I put the link in the corner, so you can check it out. So now you know what I have learned over the years about exterior images. And I need to say that after implementing these things, my exterior images improved a lot. And I hope they will help you as well. Thanks for watching. If Advanced Exterior Visualization course sounds interesting for you, don't forget to check it out. I guarantee tons of great knowledge. and don't forget about plenty of bonuses you will get to the course. You can check exactly what is included on our website. Click here to check it out. Bye bye!